Hey guys, welcome back to some more F1 2016 and part 23 of the Return to Glory career mode with McLaren, and we have the second race of season 2 today at the Bahrain Grand Prix. I'm really looking forward to this. Let's get into things. We have that huge update. If you haven't seen the last episode, go check it out now. It is a belter, I promise you that. Probably my favourite episode so far, just because of all the variation in it. It really was enjoyable to race in that Grand Prix. And here we are, the R&D update. There's Chris the engineer. Good to see you back after the winter.
The factory sent over the parts that were looking good on the rig. They're being fitted as we speak. Have a look at the report.
And here we go. Let's have a look at what we have. I can't remember what updates I actually got. I just know it's a big update. Here we go then. Engine power. The pistons have been upgraded. Another 8 brake horsepower. We've upgraded the chassis weight now. So we've lost 5 kilograms there. That's going to give us a few tenths. The drag's been reduced. So we've lost 2.4% of drag, which means we're going to have a lot more straight line speed. Anymore? No more new parts. Let's see which other teams have upgraded. And it just looks to be Toro Rosso. So let's have a look at the R&D standings. We are now the fastest team on the grid, apparently. Red Bull in second with the Phantom update that nobody's seen. Mercedes down to third now, so they're struggling very much with the development race. Ferrari there in fourth, Williams fifth, Toro Rosso with their upgrade moving to sixth. But it is very close between the top six teams, and then there's sort of a second tier after that with Haas, Force India, Manor, Renault, and then Sauber just in a league of their own at the back of the grid. So hopefully you guys have enjoyed the first part of this episode. I was just about to end it there. And with that being said, let's hand over now to the story of qualifying with Joe. No, I won't, guys. Yet again, I recorded, the practice part of this way back in October, and now it's February, so we're going to get on with the race. All you really need to know is that it's a 1-2 for McLaren. We just edged out Fernando, and yeah, it was a difficult one. We had a bit of a ding-dong battle all weekend, and obviously David Croft will take us through the grid any minute now, really, so enjoy the introduction, I think. No, here we are. So that's the points we've earned. We're ahead of Nico Rosberg. It's going to be difficult to actually beat him in the, what do you call it, the rivalry. Let's listen to what Emma has to say.
Where are you? I have some information on the race goals you should keep in mind.
So apparently we need to finish second and beat both our rival Nico Rosberg and Fernando Alonso. So it's just so difficult to go back to this game so long after I recorded the last one. We obviously had 3 wins last season and 3 other second places. 2 wins last season, 3 second places and a third place, which was a pretty good season, not going to lie. And we're leading the championship at the moment because of the first race, which was brilliant. But yeah, I'll hand over to David Croft to take me through the start of this race.
The curtain rises once more then on the desert stage of Sakhir as the players take their places for the opening act. Will they enthrall us like they did in 2014 with that titanic battle between Nico Rosberg and Lewis Hamilton? Well, we'll find out shortly as we get underway here in Bahrain. Formula One returns to the desert today on this exceptional 3.36 mile circuit. 15 corners provide plenty of overtaking opportunities, and 2 DRS zones will help with that as well. It could be a strategic race, this one, with Sakir notorious for eating up the rear tyres. Watch out for drivers managing their rubber at some points during the Grand Prix. I won't be commentating alone today, of course. Nope, I have the honour to share this commentary box with none other than Anthony Davidson. And you and I were talking earlier today about how tight that midfield battle is compared to the last couple of years. Why do you think that is?
Well, I suppose the main reason is simply stability in the regulations. Look at what we had towards the end of the V8 era. In 2012, we had 7 winners in 7 races. We talk about the dominance of Red Bull at that time, but their advantage was rarely more than 2 or 3 tenths of a second. And we've had this current formula now for a couple of years, and that serves to solve any teething troubles with reliability. And let's not forget that these cars are more technical than ever before, so it was always going to take a bit of time for those gaps to come down.
You've done well to put it on pole, but we've still got work to do. Trying to cover the inside line off the start.
Well then, after an exciting qualifying session yesterday, let's take a look at how the cars line up. It's McLaren in pole position then. And starting alongside is Fernando Alonso. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Ricciardo, Verstappen, Lewis Hamilton, and Rosberg, Vettel, Bottas, Massa, and Carlos Sainz. Raikkonen, Gutierrez, Romain Grosjean, and Kvyat, Hülkenberg, Perez, Pascal Wehrlein, and Jolyon Palmer, Harry Anto, and Magnussen. Felipe Nasser and Marcus Ericsson rounds off the grid. Now it's almost time to lights out, so let's go down to the track.
Right then, guys, we are back and pole position. Now I haven't played this game since October either, so it could go horrendously wrong. Apparently that's a strategy. I don't really know what's happened here, because I'm sure it's meant to be a night race, but hey-ho, probably a glitch. But let's get into things. Obviously we've got the formation lap to begin with here, so that'll give us a bit of a chance to feel the clutch, and well, we've already been outstarted by Alonso. But there's been a few patches since the last time I played it, so I don't really know what my skill level's going to be now. I'm hoping that I'm still going to be okay at the game. I like to feel like I'm pretty decent at it, usually. So, yeah, we'll just have to see what happens. Obviously, a very, very close qualifying session, as you can see. Us and Fernando really, really battling it out. But, yeah, plans for this season. Obviously, this is the first time I've really been able to talk about it, you know, from a live perspective. Knowing what I do know now in February, what I didn't know in October. I think this is going to be a good second season. I'm hoping to finish the second season and then maybe move on to another team after that. I really don't know. We'll just have to see what you guys think, what the views are like, what the feedback's like, and what my time constraints are, because a lot of things have changed in my life since the last time I played Formula One, so we'll just have to see. But if you keep smashing that like button and leaving good comments down below and letting us know that I'm at least doing an okay job and keeping you guys entertained, then that'll motivate me to keep getting these videos out. They do take a lot of time to make, and we are going to move the race length down to 25% after this race, so please don't hold that against us. It's literally just because of time constraints. So here we are lining up on the grid. Everybody seems to be fairly close behind us, which is decent, so we shouldn't take too long. But this is certainly going to be a very interesting start of the Grand Prix. I had a couple of practice laps before I threw myself into this, and this is going to be very interesting indeed. If we win this, it'll be one of the most remarkable wins of the series so far. But here we go. Can we get our fourth career win? We're going over to the real start now. We'll hold the clutch. We'll get our RPM right. Lights out, away we go here in Bahrain. A very good start for us here. Fernando Alonso a little bit slow off the line. Ricciardo and Hamilton off to a good start. And they're coming down our inside. We're just holding the outside line. Alonso back into second place. And well, here we go. We're going to hopefully defend this position. Coming up into turn four. Fernando Alonso having a quick look behind us. We break nicely down into the end of the first sector. Somehow I've managed to keep all four wheels on the track so far, and we're still leading this Grand Prix. If this is the case at the end of the session, I'll certainly be very surprised. There's our first mistake of sorts. It looks like Verstappen's had a terrible start. He's gone down to fifth place. Hamilton, the one to benefit from that, up in the fifth. Obviously, Nico Rosberg has retired from Formula One now, which is very different to our timeline. And yeah, it's certainly going to make a very interesting 2017 season. But we're not worried about that now. We're just worried about staying in first position and hopefully building a bit of a lead over Fernando Alonso in second place. A decent second sector, but we do go wide in the first turn of the third sector. Now Alonso, he's just far enough behind us to make sure that he's not much of an issue. But yeah, we come down into the final corner and we end the first lap, and we can hopefully breathe a little bit now, which is good. Set the fastest lap in the process, and hopefully we can settle down a bit. Virtual safety car's out. Ricciardo was the man to be out of the race, so that's one of our rivals gone. We need to get this delta down. Whew. Just about did. That could have been bad. Yeah, difficult keeping the delta up. Lap 5 obviously now, and we're not doing too badly. We got a couple of second lead over Fernando Alonso, waiting for the green flag, and there we go. We'll start once again at racing speed, which is good. I think we're going to come into the pits this lap, because look at our front left tyre. And here we go. Into the pits. Might as well stay with the action. Now let's see how I manage to get this down to the limit. That's not too bad. Not too bad at all. So how have the pit crew been training since October? Hopefully well. We're going on to the medium tyres. We're away 2.2 seconds. That's a pretty damn good pit stop, and we're going to be away in 15th position, just behind the banana cars, so that's not too bad. And well, we're just behind Ericsson. We would have liked to have come out in front of him, but that's not too bad. We'll just settle into these tyres. There's yellow flags out. I don't know what's happened here, but somebody's had a big incident up ahead. We're going to have to make our way through this. Rio Haryanto out of the race. Apparently we've illegally overtook Hülkenberg. But yeah, something big happened there. Haryanto out of the race. Are we going to have a safety car? It doesn't look like it. So race back underway. going to come down the inside of Pascal Wehrlein. A little bit of contact there. That's just a bit of rustiness for you. I'm going to come down the inside of Wehrlein again into this corner. Much better done there for us and the DRS, of course. But, yeah, we'll see if those yellow flags affect if we come out in the lead or not. It looks like Fernando may be coming in this lap. He is. So that'll certainly be interesting to see. We'll stay with the action. We're coming up on Nico Hülkenberg right now. Fernando in the pits. He's getting serviced now. So expecting 2 seconds. He's going to be leaving the pit lane. I think he's going to be out in front. I think those yellow flags will have screwed us over. We're coming through now. And we're going to be in third by the looks of things. Yep. Third place. Those yellow flags have spoiled our race so far. And we're now in ninth position. And we're going to have to battle back in this race. Fly past Ericsson and Hülkenberg. Them two have been battling on track. We're going to go around the outside of Nico Hülkenberg. What a move that is. Very, very good move there. But Hülkenberg coming out back at us round the outside. We managed to hold the position, but he's going to have DRS. And I don't know if the Force India is still going to be faster in a straight line than us McLaren boys. It doesn't look like it. Looks like we've produced a very, very good engine for the 2017 season. And here we go. We've now got to try and close in on Lewis Hamilton and Fernando Alonso, who are the net leaders of this Bahrain Grand Prix. Hamilton having a look on Fernando Alonso. I was just getting ready to have a cut there, but it looks like Fernando Alonso is down in the net second position. He's going to have a look back at Lewis Hamilton down the back straight. Well, not down the pit straight. This is looking very exciting up in front. Fernando Alonso, are we going to get ahead of Valtteri Bottas? That is the question. Nico Rosberg's replacement at Mercedes in real life. We just fly around the outside of him, so that's good. But it looks like Alonso is forced into second position by Lewis Hamilton. It'll be interesting to see how the Mercedes race paces this season. Very interesting start to this 2017 season then. Look at this battle up ahead. Three wide. They're going into turn one. Raikkonen is ahead of us as well. I really don't know how all these cars have got such a good advantage over us in the pit stops. I don't know if these have actually pitted yet. Oh, Fernando Alonso's out. Well, he might not be out, but he certainly took a lot of, well, time loss, really. I don't know how much damage he's took, but we're certainly going to have a look on the replay camera. So it looks like a Haas is leading the Grand Prix. This isn't the battle that we want, though. Hamilton there, and then Fernando Alonso coming round, having a look, just clipping the front wing, and he went off sideways onto the grass. And well, Fernando Alonso is certainly going to be affected by that. He has been incredibly unlucky in this save, and we're now right behind Kimi Raikkonen, so that's helped us out in the process. And we're in a net third place at the moment. We need to get past Kimi Raikkonen and Lewis Hamilton if we want to convert our pole position into the race win. We'll stick with the action. Valtteri Bottas has kept pretty much glued to the back of our car, which is interesting for him, just to see the Williams performing so well. But we've got DRS on Raikkonen, so if we can stay within this sort of distance through the final sector, we should be able to make a move on the pit straight. We've got superior downforce to this Ferrari, just superior pace, to be honest with you. And we're looking good going through that second sector now, certainly setting a couple of personal bests. Hamilton has caught the Haas in front. We're going to try and maybe get past Raikkonen already, and we're going to go down the inside into the final corner. I think we just strategically maybe got DRS there. Grosjean pits. Have we got DRS? No, we haven't. But we've got very good straight line speed anyway. Very, very good straight line speed from the Williams of Bottas. So he goes down the inside. And what a move that is for him. We're going to stick around the outside. And that becomes the inside line into turn two. And now into turn three. This is very interesting indeed. Bottas having a look. Maybe around the outside. We're just going to stick to the inside line and defend it like it's the last thing that we're going to do. We're now going to hopefully close in on Lewis Hamilton, the 2014 and 2015 world champion, and 2008 as well, actually. So three-time world champion, of course, Lewis Hamilton. But more relevant is the fact that he is leading this Grand Prix. That would be a terrific victory for Mercedes, who only qualified 5th and 6th for this race. Lewis Hamilton got off to that good start, remember, and got past Verstappen on the first lap. That set him up to be in a good position. But remember, he's on the slower tyre. We are on the more durable white-walled medium tyre, whereas Lewis Hamilton's on the faster, less durable soft tyre. So, yeah, it's going to be interesting strategically whether we're in the best possible position here. When we're on this pit straight, we'll have a quick look at when we need to pit. It looks like another 6 or 7 laps yet, so we'll just move that down to standard and hopefully settle into this second position. Well, here's Valtteri Bottas. He's having a look once again, but can't make anything of it, and it looks like we live to fight another day with Bottas. Well, Rosberg's overtook us. That's pretty damn good. I don't really know what happened to Bottas, but Rosberg was our problem there throughout really the latter part of that stint. And we've just overtook him once again. Hamilton has just pitted. We have took a little bit of damage to the front wing, which is a bit unfortunate. I am just going to get a little bit of extra downforce added though, to compensate for that. We are losing a great amount of time, but I think it's more down to the tyre wear rather than the front wing at present. We're struggling a little bit. It doesn't look like we're going to win this Grand Prix. Hamilton was about 10 seconds ahead of us there, and he's just bolted into the distance, and Mercedes are looking good in this race as we get a little bit wide there, and we're struggling. Oof. That could have been bad. Could have been really, really bad. And we are struggling on those high speed turns with the lack of downforce. Rosberg having a look at us around the outside. Bottas is coming down the inside of Nico Rosberg. That's a very interesting battle. They touch tyres. And well, they both come into the pits. And we just continue on one more lap. Fernando Alonso has caught us up though, so we are definitely losing time. It's just a matter of if we can keep it cleanly on the track this lap and maybe get into the pits at the end of this one and put on a brand new set of soft tyres. We are actually going to change our front wing. We're just going to let Fernando through. We're losing too much time, and we're going to hope that safety car comes out so we can catch up. Much better entry that time. Hamilton back ahead of us already, so there's no way we're going to win this Grand Prix. But hopefully with the front wing change, brand new set of soft tyres, we'll be able to do something good here. There we go, the brand new front wing. And we're away in 8 seconds, so we've lost another 6 seconds. I think that's less than what we would lose overall in the rest of this Grand Prix if we'd just left it how it was. And we come back out in 9th behind Romain Grosjean. Sebastian Vettel has just about caught us there, which is not good, but we'll try and settle down into these soft tyres. But here's Sebastian Vettel already having a look down the inside. We're just going to hold it round the outside, roll it into turn four. He's obviously on the medium tyres, so we should be able to outperform him on these brand new soft tyres. That was a bit of a dodgy corner, but we're just going to settle down into this set of tyres and maybe have a push and try and regain a podium spot. Closing in on Valtteri Bottas, we've just set three consecutive fastest laps. So, you know, we're looking good at the moment, fastest car on the track. But we need to get past Bottas very, very quickly indeed. We've got the DRS open down the back straight. This is going to be difficult. We are just going to hold back a little bit and let the extra grip take hold round here. We slide a little bit, we make a little bit of contact. Oh dear, Bottas is gone. Now then, was that our fault? That's what we have to decide right now. We didn't get a penalty for it. There we go, we make a bit of contact, we come round the outside. It's just a bit of a racing incident really. More unfortunate for Bottas than it was for me, but we'll certainly settle for it. We're in fifth and we're now going to close down on our teammate Fernando Alonso. And hopefully, we're not going to set a fourth consecutive fastest lap. We're going to be about a second down here, you would imagine. Yep. But we've took over Verstappen and now it's the battle for the podium against our teammate and two-time world champion Fernando Alonso. Coming into the final lap then, we've just ran out of laps really, and ran out of tyres in the Rosberg battle. It's certainly been tough, we've been pushing as hard as we can, and yeah, just haven't managed to get really that close. We're certainly really, really trying, we've shaved tenths off here and there, but Rosberg's been very consistent on those medium tyres and he's going to get a deserved podium out of it. We're just struggling on the old marbles. We're getting the closest we've ever been here. So maybe one more chance, perhaps. Big lock up here. Are we going to make the corner? We do. And, well, we are still technically in this race for third place, but it is going to be difficult. Fuel levels aren't looking particularly brilliant either. We may run out of fuel here. Lewis Hamilton has won the Grand Prix. And it looks like Fernando Alonso is going to come through in second place. We just haven't quite got enough in the battle with Rosberg. We have battled on and on and on though. And we've managed to come through in fourth place. Unlucky in the end there. The yellow flags costed us, really, in that early lap, whenever it was. But that backed us into traffic where we lost a bit of work. We're front wing and that's cost us second place today. Lewis Hamilton was very, very good though and deserved his victory from fifth place on the grid, remember. And Nico Rosberg, his teammate, finishing in third with Fernando Alonso in second there. And yeah, there's Sergio Perez, he finished ninth. He looks happy with that. Looks like you stepped out of a Red Bull there for some reason. But there we go, there's your top three, Fernando Alonso, Lewis Hamilton, and Nico Rosberg. And their tyres certainly looked a lot better than ours at the end there. We just ran out, really. Probably pitted a lap too early on the mediums, but we were just losing a little bit too much time. And that's a shame. But, yeah, Lewis Hamilton run now victor there. Kimi Raikkonen in 5th, Max Verstappen in 6th, Bottas in 7th, Vettel 8th, Perez 9th, and Nico Hülkenberg in 10th. The non-finishers are Ricciardo, Harry Anto, and Felipe Massa. So we still lead by 6 points in the Drivers' Championship. Lewis Hamilton moving up to 2nd and Fernando Alonso in 3rd. Constructors-wise, McLaren are leading by 21 points over Mercedes racing. Let's see what happens in the little post-race thing. I think Nico Rosberg will now win the rivalry, I want to say. Pardon me. Big yawns. There's some extra R&D points. He's going to win it, is he? Oh, very, very close. He's going to have a DNF in the next race if we're to beat him. Or at least draw with him. Draw's looking the most likely scenario at this moment in time. We're going to drop out of the overachieving thing though, I think. Or are we going to go back up here? Yeah, we are. So we're at 9 on that. There's our total career score. And that is going to be that this episode. So, hopefully you guys have enjoyed. Please leave a like down below if you did. You don't have to, of course, but it would be love for me and for the channel. And I hope you guys are having a wonderful day. Thanks for watching, and goodbye.